And welcome to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March Part 2. Yes, it is now available, and is available for me to be playing it. About 9 months later. Nine and a half. Anyway, this is the RPG chick. I haven't played this game actually since February is when I finished the White March Part 1. And now we're obviously playing Part 2. And I'm going to thereafter complete the game. I'm going to try to defeat the two dragons, the one at the bottom of the Cadnua, and which is in the main game, and the one off in that cave in White March Part 1. If I can't defeat them, I'm not going to include that. But we will be defeating Thiadess at the end of the game. Mark my words. We kind of had him on the ropes originally. But then I found out, well, with part two, we can increase our level and stuff like that. So we should be able to defeat him unless he's scaling with our level. But I'll try my best anyway. So what do we got here? Install, installed, installed. Okay. So we're going to load or continue. Oh, by the way, if you want access to the White March Part 1, I'll put a link somewhere around here, and the base game of Pillars of Eternity, I'll put an annotation here. And of course, I'm having this as part of the same playlist as White March Part 1, so if you look in the description of the video, you'll find the playlist there, so you can access all of the White March material. Main game is in a separate playlist, and of course you can click there to get to it. My LP number 57. Continuing right from that console hot. Console hot. We defeated console hot. We have his special little skull. And may or may not be a little nod to Planescape Torment. Anyway, you have completed Pillars of Eternity, The White March Part 1. Correct. Yes, to begin the next chapter of the story, rest in any location outside of the White March. Now, we're at Cadnua, so all we have to do is rest here. High-level wizards, druids, and priests low-level per-encounter spells have been replaced with spell mastery. Level up your casters to select qualifying spells. New task, a call to the court.
Is another foreign colony.
Yeah, possibly. A messenger from the Ducal Palace in Defiance Bay has arrived at Cadnua. Speak to the messenger in the Great Hall. New quest, the Forgotten Army. Now I read everything in these games. So, I'll be reading dialogues and such. The White Forge has been restored thanks to your efforts in the White March. The White Forge, sorry. I should depart the White March and rest. In time, stalwart should begin to mend. Excellent. That's the skull. Okay, I guess I don't get to level up and do spell mastery. It's only Aeloth and Durance here. Now, I haven't played this for 10 months, so please bear with me.
Hi?
I'm gonna be a little rusty with such certain things. Mastering a spell allows a free use of that spell once per encounter. Wizards mastered spells do not need to be in the grimoire in order to gain the free use. Okay, so let me choose on this. Some of these I do not remember at all. The only bad thing about using spells like this is you have to bring your wizard into melee range, which I, you know, try to avoid if possible. I do really like the minor missiles. I use them when all my other missiles have been depleted. Thrust of Tattered Veils. These are all level 1 spells, so this would mean nothing. This can be neat, knocked down, but does no damage at all. Let's choose Minoletta's Minor Missiles. And for this, Corrosive Siphon. So I'm not completely sure, but some of these may be spells that we gained after defeating Council Hunt. Corrosive damage. I kind of like that one. Yeah, let's take that one. Again. Getting in melee range. Not something I like to do with this particular character. Crackling Bolt is like your lightning bolt spell from AD&D. The only bad thing with this is it can also hit your friends. I'm pretty sure. So I'm probably going to go with Fireball. Bounding Missiles would be good too. I've used some kind of spell similar to that, but not that one especially. 29 to 40 burn damage versus Reflex. Yeah, Fireball. I like Fireball. I understand Fireball. We'll take Fireball. Endurance. Bong! Now, Blessing is a pretty neat spell. I do like using it. Whenever possible. This, though, is a nice debuff. Look at it. Decreases all these things. And does piercing damage. I think we'll take that. Consecrated Ground is neat. Doesn't give that much endurance back, though. Divine Mark. That's a nice buff. How about Holy Power? Hopefully I remember to use these things. Circle of Protections. Good. Dire Blessing. Pillar of Faith, I do enjoy using that. It's a pretty neat spell to see in action, actually. Whoops. I'm freaking the thing out. Prayer Against Restraint. Pillar of Faith.
Indeed.
Eh?
So we're at Cadnua. Here's our map. A little worried about that. Looks like a graphical artifact, which I had problems in the beginning of Pillars, White March Part 1. So I hope stuff like this doesn't persist. And then you have the fast mode for running up quickly. Now, from what I saw of reviews, I did see some spoiler... I did read a couple spoiler-free reviews they were saying that the first White March is more role-playing. So, which is neat. I did off-screen look at, you know, talk to these people. Well, not him, but these guys. Messenger, and there was somebody else over here. And, yeah, look through that, and then rest it up and see, saw what happened after. And, yeah, we're supposed to go back to the White March. We have a strange dream. Other than that, completely blind, so I really don't know what's happening. I know there's some new strange creatures that have no eyes or something like that. And that's about it. That's all I know. Waiting on your orders, m'lady. I'm hoping they have a lot of voice acting, because the White March Part 1 had a lot more voice acting than in the base game. I bear a message from the Ducal Palace. Just a moment of your time, m'lady. There's some other guy, Benrolt. Greetings, m'lady. I bear an urgent message from Chancellor Warren of Defiance Bay. He requests that you meet with him at your earliest convenience in the Ducal Palace. Your claim on Cadnua has been called into question by the Gathbin family, whoever the hell they are. Earl Badamar has issued a ruling on the matter, but both you and Lord Gathbin must be present. Cadnua is mine. The Gathbin family disagrees, as your claim is not based on lineage. An official ruling is required to remedy this dispute. Well, who's Chancellor Warren? He's an arbiter of legal matters for Earl Badamar of the Grasp. And tell me about this Lord Gathbin, then. An old Adirian lineage, I believe. He looks around the Great Hall. The former lord of this stronghold, a distant relative of Lord Gathbin, allied himself with the losing side during the War of Defiance. I'll go meet him, then. The Chancellor will await you in the records room of the Ducal Palace in First Fires. The messenger bows, then strides away. Cool. Updated. Travel to the Ducal Palace in the First Fires District of Defiance Bay. My ownership of Cadnua is in doubt. I must meet with Chancellor Warren in Ducal Palace in First Fires to discuss the matter. Well, I discovered the place. It's mine, fair and square. Plus the lady of the place here, you know, has bid me welcome. Let's talk to Beralt. Greetings, Lady Thiadess. My name is Beralt. If you have the time, I have an urgent matter I'd like to discuss. Very well, let's hear it. You call for your allies and prepare to hear the petition. I have been tasked with meeting with representatives from the Fisher Crane tribe near Thayan Bog. It's my hope to come to peaceful terms. Unfortunately, I haven't had much practice with the Glamfellen language, and the Fisher Crane are, by nature, very occlusive. I fear that the circumstances are ripe for a misunderstanding. You yourself, I hear, have had some dealings with the Glamfellens. I would welcome any assistance or advice you may offer. Oh, I could give advice, a safe passage, or have someone escort. Who would we have escort? I don't know. Hopefully not someone currently in our party. I'll have someone escort you. Oh, with whom will I be traveling? Okay. We really don't use Haravius and never had much of an interest in him. So Haravius is Glamfellen. His knowledge of the region should be helpful. Thank you, m'lady. We'll set out right away. Ravius will be busy for 6 days. Fine. I actually forgot all about him. Poor guy. Azuro. Hail, Azuro. Good tidings, my lady. I am Azuro, famed merchant, purveyor of many valuable and, dare I say, rare objects. And so I would like to remain. I have an urgent matter to discuss with you, something you'll want resolved as quickly as I am certain. Very well, let's hear it. I don't know why this little change here. We were already speaking to him, but we have to go sit down to continue speaking to him. It's these bandits, my lord. The roads are absolutely crawling with them, and they have the local merchants in a fright. I'm having trouble filling out my stock. My suppliers say the risk is too great. Nobody wants to hear that the fineries sent out for delivery have been stolen by unwashed brigands. If I have no goods to sell, I cannot make a living, nor can I offer you the many special items normally at my disposal. I'll have one of my allies assist you. Marvelous. I'd welcome such assistance. Okay, I don't want to give up Adair or Palagina. Pretty sure I was pronouncing it Palagina. On second thought, maybe not. I see. Another idea, perhaps? I'll put an end to this. Yes, my lord. What is it you have planned? He watches you curiously, his hands folded eagerly in front of him. Well, we could either give him 5,000 copper. How much copper do we even have? I don't even know. It would be helpful if they show that to us. Or... Being as I don't know how much copper I currently have, I'll take the aggressive route. Bandits will be the least of their worries if those merchants don't open up the supply lines. I'm certain they'll come around, my lady. Thank you for stepping in. Once everything is in order, I'm sure I'll have more goods to offer you. We really didn't do anything. I mean, hopefully we wrote something down. Can we talk to her again? The steward. I trust all is well, my lady. Please let me know if there's anything I can do to help. What is the state of the keep? Ah, where to begin? Let's see here. This brings her up. Okay. Oh, we still have this issue. Sagani is assigned, but it says assign. And now it's gone. Leaving in 12 hours, offering Sith Gwen. What is that? Okay, right. Scath Gwenek. Well, it's a medium shield. Maybe Palagina can use it? I'm not sure what kind of shield she's using. Plus 12 shield deflection, superb item, grants winter wind, 3 per west, and, bash. .22 to .32 freeze damage with a 2 meter push. Accuracy plus 10 versus fortitude. Seems neat. Found in one of the early raids of the Anguithan ruins in the White March. Scath, I don't know how to say that actually. Scuth? I don't know what this umlaut whatever means. Symbol, what have you. Accent, mark. Anyway, Winter Shield was given to the Adirin Lord Thane in charge of Fort Bonepicker. That's quite a name. Unaware of the shield's power and too vain to trust in an artifact from the ruins, the Lord Thane hung it in the council chambers of the fort as a symbol of Adir's mastery over White March and its native tribe, Stone Bramble. Well, I don't see a need to hire more people. What do we have now? Let's see.
I'm ready.
She's using a two-handed sword. She can't use a shield. Don't believe... Oh, she is using a shield, actually. A medium shield. This has a lot of neat stuff to it. I'm not sure which I enchanted and which I didn't. So I'm going to leave that as is. Oh, I actually use a shield. It's a small one, though. I'm pretty sure if I upgrade to large, I start having penalties to something. That's quite a coat of armor there. The golden scales. Yeah, we'll skip on that then. We don't need that.
I'm going.
Oh. Wait for us. We have to go sleep.
Gelade.
Oh.
Well done. A formidable fortress in the old style. We don't build them like this anymore, you know. Not by the sea. Too vulnerable to cannons.
Thanks for that. We have to go sleepy time now. In there. Yeah, a little rusty on where things are and stuff. Vicious war criminal. Yeah. Something you want? Alright. I think the one I was preferring was the Woodland Trails bonus. As you sleep, you are buoyed and buffeted by the vagaries of dreams. They tumble and thrash about you and fill your mind's eye with pale, glittering motes. They resolve into a light snowfall and a biting northerly wind. You recognize the mountains of the White March rising around you, and you shiver. You see Starward a few miles away, quiet and still, but for a few curling dreams of smoke rising from the chimneys. Durgan's battery is perched above it, its shadow stretching into the valley. Above it all, you hear a deep, slow rhythm. At first, it sounds like a distant drumming, but then it grows louder, cracking through the dry air and booming from the mountain peaks. It builds until you feel it reverberating beneath your feet. Watch and listen. Each thud comes louder and faster than the next. Thunder echoes from the mountaintops as great sheets of ice and snow tumble down the slopes. But the rhythm keeps building, shattering frozen lakes like crystal saucers. New ravines split through the mountains as old chasms fill with snow and scree. A rock slide buries Stalwart, and Durgan's battery is shaken into rubble. Well, I'm glad I didn't go to those places then. Shadows rise over the mountains. The vanguard of a massive army. You flee. You tumble from the foothills and bound across the Deerwood, feeling the rumble of the advancing army all the while. Let's seek refuge in Defiance Bay. The city walls rise before you, but the portcullis is lowered. Guards stand on the other side, shouting and jabbing their pikes through the bars. Stay away! Haven't you done enough already? A breeze carries the scent of smoke and charred flesh. Defiance Bay's survivors peer at you from shattered windows and cracked doors. There will be no rest for you here. You run, hearing the army ever closer behind you. We're like Forrest Gump running through this continent. Hide in Twin Elms. You reach the palisades and stone arches of the Glamfellen city. You hope to find sanctuary amidst the ancient ruins, but instead you find the gates bristling with guards. Turn back, Estremor! Take your curse far from our sacred halls. They glare at you over the tips of spears and knocked arrows. With the rumbling growing closer, you have no choice but to flee elsewhere. And we have no choice but to barricade ourselves in Cadnua. Cadnua rises from the forest, its walls, though only half mended, promising safety. Hey, I fixed that whole thing up. You barricade yourself within the Great Hall as the pounding grows closer still. It rattles the foundations of the Great Keep, and just as the masonry begins shaking loose, you hear an unholy battle cry coming from your courtyard. The ceiling collapses and sends a cascade of bricks and beams onto your head. You struggle to wakefulness, kicking at the bedding knotted around your legs. As you shake free of the last bonds of sleep, you hear a voice whisper something in a language you've never heard, and you see an image of 100 shifting, staring eyes. You awaken, feverishly warm and covered in sweat. Somehow, even though I only had the dream, the party gained experience. The Forgotten Army. In my dream, the army came from the White March near Stalwart. Perhaps the residents will know of it.
Last thing the Deerwood needs is another foreign colony.
Yes, you've told us such. Now, from here on in, we're completely blind. This stuff is coming back to me. Let's go to first fight. Oh, first we have to go. Where are we? Okay, we are here. Right, okay. We can't travel until we get to the edge of the map that we're in. Here. I'll keep the party as is. Let's go to First Fires and take care of this right away. It's only going to take 22 and a half hours. Rizzaro is on his way. Good. Now, I believe it was in Crucible Keep. Adira Noble, well, you're gonna have to hang out. White March Part 2. Okay, here's the stuff. When did this happen? Igadir came to the White March searching for his soul twin, but somebody killed him in the lonely mountain passes. I found the final wisps of his soul in the wilds east of Stalwart. Right. Ah, right. This whole thing is the dragon that we could not defeat. That's why that's still here. I refuse to kill this Thristwin. So that's why that's still there. And the master below is the other dragon. So, the Forgotten Army. Seek information. Theos. Council of Stars. That's Theos as well. Ah, tasks. Ducal Palace. I can't return to her, Rimda, because she is... I mean, you guys can pause if you want to read this stuff. I made the mistake of killing somebody. Well, he attacked me when I tried to get into a room, so I defend myself and kill him. And I actually killed a bunch of people in there. And now I can't do this quest because she will just try to attack me. And I'm not giving the kid a steel dagger. So those are the quests that I haven't done. So, yeah, Ducal Palace, which I guess is that. a little green worm of friends. Greetings, Justice Yar. Dunstan's as gifted an armor as you'll find in the entire city. I agree. He did great work for us. Made something for us. A breastplate or something. It's been almost a year, guys. Chancellor Warren is awaiting me at the Hall of Records inside the Ducal Palace. Hall of Records. Shrine of Magrin. Hall of Records. Oh my, look at the time now. Okay. Sorry to leave it on such an anticlimactic ending for this episode, but we're already about 33 minutes in, give or take. So thanks for watching, and tune back next time when we fight for the right for Cad Nua. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.